Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to the Casual Couch. Before we leave here, I would like to go get the Power Within Pyromancy, and I think also the Wanderer set. Because I think the Wanderer set might work for the time being in terms of fashion. I really am not extremely fond of the Pyromancer equipment. That will be a relatively quick run. And actually, I should have rested at the bonfire at the base of the elevator. But I didn't think of it at the time. There is treasure over there, but I'm pretty sure it's just the server, which is... Well, actually, I was gonna say, the server is one of the three curved greatswords in this game. It's, I think, with little debate, the worst one, in fact. But it might actually absorb a little bit more health than the butcher knife per hit. Now I just need to get rid of these boulder rolling jerks, and also, of course, blasted mosquitoes. These guys, interestingly enough, can drop a weapon that is really good for strength builds. They can drop the pickaxe. And in fact, they're the only enemy in the game that drops the pickaxe. The pickaxe has the same moveset as the battleaxe, but it does only thrust damage. So it synergizes very well with the Leo Ring, as does the War Pick, which you can buy from Andre, but the War Pick does not scale very well, whereas the pickaxe has very, very good strength scaling for a smaller sized weapon. But I think that should be the last of them. No, it's a great club. Right. Well, there was a server over here some... No, you know what? I think the server is closer to the other end of the swamp. I mixed up its location with this weapon. And actually, the Great Club isn't such a useful weapon anyway. The Large Club has almost the same, if not identical, strength scaling. Almost identical reach. An almost identical moveset, except I think for the strong R2, rather the two-handed strong attack. This, I believe, should be... Nope! Okay, that's Poison Mist, and the Pyromancer set. I think server was over in the far corner by some leeches, if I remember correctly. Right near the entrance to the Great Hollow. The leeches, by the way, are a good place to farm green titanite shards if you're trying to make divine or elemental weapons. Tell you what, I really love the thrust attack on the Gravelord Greatsword. It is so handy. Thrust attacks in this game are really useful, not only because they are capable of dealing bonus damage during an enemy's attack or evasion animation, which is known as a counter hit, but also because thrust attacks tend to have really long range. I believe it's right over here. Oh, I guess not. And therefore, thrust attacks are really handy for baiting enemies into running toward you. And then attacking them as they charge. A thrust attack will often reach an enemy before it can hit you. Uh-oh. The leeches are another one of those dog and rat type enemies that like to attack in groups and are pretty good at stunlocking you, so it's important not to take on too many of them at a time. That acid spit will also break your equipment, so you have to be careful of that. Well, that did not go quite the way I was hoping. As you can see here, the trick is just to stay to their sides, to kind of strafe around them, so that they can't line up their jump attack on you. Because if you're directly in front of them, or only slightly to their side, it can be a little bit trickier. Oh my god, that collision. The leeches like to hang out over here. They can also drop large titanite shards in addition to the green ones. Alright, let's see. What you want to do here is lure them away one at a time if you can, because if you have to deal with more than one at once, as you just saw there when I had to fight two, it gets pretty hairy pretty quickly. There we are. And there is Server. All right, 24 strength. I should just barely be able to use it, actually. And I believe this is the weapon which drains 8 HP per attack that you connect. As you can see, it has the worst range of any of the curved greatswords. It's an interesting looking weapon. I believe it is modeled after some of the tribal weapons that originate from the African subcontinent. But its moveset? The thrust attack on the Gravelord Greatsword is much, much better. Unfortunately. Which is a shame, because... the curved greatswords are a really underutilized weapon class in this game. As are fist weapons and whips. You know, a lot of them suffered that treatment, unfortunately, but... I ought to actually... switch to a weapon that is capable of doing some damage. And I think I'm going to head to the bonfire and rest there first. There we are. That will get those enemies off my back. That wasn't helpful. You bastards. Problem with these stupid insects is that they continually respawn. There's a spot in the swamp where they just pop out of the ground. And they continually harass you. So getting back up here is tricky. Ordinarily, this is the way you would be entering Blight Town. Actually. No, okay, that's further up. There's a blow dart guy above me, whom I want to get rid of. Unfortunately, the blow dart guys are one-time spawns. Get lost. There is the Wanderer set. And a falchion. In case you like mashing R1. Further up here is what we're really after. And that is the power within pyromancy. Now you want to be careful as you climb this ladder. You want to wait for this thing to turn around. Because otherwise he'll just gank you the minute you hit the top of the ladder. Now, you can go through here. I think. Oh, yeah, you can, but... if I remember correctly, anyway, walking off here is... oh, no. Yeah, I think this might be death, actually. This is where you land if you fall down from up above. I don't know. My memory of the geography of this area is a little bit fuzzy, to be entirely honest. And there's our good buddy Blowdart guy again. It is quite irritating how far away these guys can reach you. You have to be careful in here because I believe there's going to be a guy up above me. Who, if you run... Oh, well, blow dart guy fell off a cliff and died. Like when that happens. You have to walk slowly because there's a guy up here who will... If you don't walk... This dude will slide down the ladder and block your path. It was this spot. If you fall down from up here, there's a whip down on that platform there. And then, of course, there are a couple of these guys. Or I guess there's one. I thought for some reason there were two. Maybe not. And then somebody very angry saw me and is going to want a piece. There he goes. Well, he can't seem to figure out how to path to me. What an idiot. Well, I think there's a second one somewhere around here who's gonna... Yeah, that was a grab attack he was just about to use. A very dangerous grab attack where he hits you multiple times and does lots of damage, and it's just ugly and nasty for everyone involved. There are some guys up above me, but I'm not sure if they can actually reach me. Now, I believe this path leads behind the enemy I want to fight. I think this is that path. There's Blow Dart Guy. Yeah, I think this might be it. Yes, it is. So this path here... This is another thing these guys are good at, is stun locking. They've got some shove attacks. These are essentially analogous, these enemies, to the... The plague guys in the Valley of Defilement. Oh god. Damn it. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Oh, I was trying to roll. And I got stuck on the collision, because the collision in here is not the greatest. A lot of the spots where the paths meet the ground can get you stuck. Which is not helpful. Of course, it also didn't help that I was wearing a ring, which was not doing anything for me. Alright, well, let's make our way back up there then. You can generally bypass most of this stuff. God. I was about to say you can bypass most of this stuff if you can get by the chaos bug blocking this ramp. If you can do that, you're in the clear. Run straight up that ladder, and then you walk slowly up this next one here. Walk slowly to the base, you climb up, and if you walk, this guy won't turn to face the top of the ladder. Of course, I kind of botched that, but... there we are. I guess I will switch back to the Gravelord's sword, because... apparently, I need a little bit more damage output up here. I don't remember those plague guys as having quite that much health, but it seems they do. And they are definitely intent on preventing me from... making any progress in there. Yeah, you can see here, at a walking speed, I get stuck on the start of this wooden platform. And it pushes me to the side here. There we are. And then this guy... this guy will go down much faster. Oh, I don't want to try standing behind him there. Get lost, would you? Not even any items. So now I have to deal with this again. Now, this bastard here, he's guarding the power within pyromancy. This guy is essentially modeled on the primeval demons from Demon Souls. If you try and get close to him, he'll just kick you. That's what he does. That's all he does. Oh, somebody fell and died. That's helpful. Now, you can just cheese him with ranged attacks, but... if you do go this way... you can get behind him instead, and I think there might be a little bit of additional treasure there. Before anything else, I want my bloodstain back. I want to get rid of the plague guys who are going to find their way to me. Nobody else here? All right. Guess it's just in here then. Get rid of that stuff, so it's not blocking my path. Right, I forgot he came from that direction. There's a little monster closet back there where those guys hide. There we go. It's hard to see where they come from up here, because not only is it dark, but there are lots of little nooks and crannies where these punks like to hide. Oh, somebody else fell to their death too. Great. So you can drop down here, and that positions you so that you come out behind the primeval demon. You come out right behind his big, ugly red butt, and from here, you can just butt stab him. And poof. Gone. I could have sworn there was some treasure in here, though. At least I thought there was, but I guess not. I guess it's just the path back behind him. At any rate, that gets you the power within pyromancy, from which point you can just bone back to the bonfire. Bonfire. Bonfire? Yeah, that works too, I guess. And you're home free, so now we can finally take our leave of this crazy place. And make our way back up to Firelink Shrine. It'll be a relief to be done here, I'll tell you that much. I am not gonna miss this place. Fortunately, the worst of it is over, though. The worst of it is coming down through those platforms. And ordinarily, the way the game is set up with the intended path, you would be coming down here through the depths. So you would start off way over in that direction, straight ahead of me where all those torches are. You would start off at the top of a completely different set of scaffolding over there, and have to work your way down to the bottom of Blighttown through a really heavily populated section of narrow pathways with tons of ambushes by those plague guys, by insects, by some of those fire-breathing dogs. It's just a bad time. So that's one of the other benefits to going through New Londo via the Master Key instead, is that it allows you to bypass all of that crap. You know, and actually, before we head back to Firelink Shrine... No, we should go to Firelink Shrine first, because we'll be able to save a little more time if we handle it this way. I was going to say, before we go back to Firelink, I should head for Darkroot Basin again and free Dusk, because I want the piece of headgear that you get for saving her. But first things first, we'll go set our respawn point at Firelink, then we'll head for Darkroot Basin so that I can just warp back to Firelink straight away. And also, I think it might be a little bit faster to get to Firelink via the Undead Parish. Or if not faster, then at the very least a little safer and easier. And actually, it occurs to me I won't be able to set my home point at Firelink now anyway, because the Firekeeper's dead. And in order to restore her...
Oh, it's you. You rescued Milady. Well, a pity that is, for it will amount to nothing, for the little madam is not worth her salt without her family name.
Now, if you leave Petrus alone beyond this point, he will eventually kill Rhea.
Come again.
Now, I don't want him to kill Rhea, because Rhea is nice. And since Petrus is not so nice, well, we have ways of dealing with people who are not so nice, don't we?
What is it, fool? Driven to madness by emotion? So be it. You'll make a fine hollow. You can waltz in the infernal depths together.
Yeah, maybe we will.
do wrong?
If you have to ask, you'll never know. 'Cause you're dead! Oh! Go me. Go me. Sick burns. And from that point onward, after you rescue Rhea, you will find her right here.
Hello. I will never forget what you did. I am deeply indebted, for it was not within my power to save Vince or Nico. I cannot thank you enough. In case you have not heard, I am Rhea of Thoroland. I only wish there was some way I could help you. But I am inexperienced and I only know the art of miracles. If that could be of any help, speak to me again.
And indeed it is, because if you have enough faith to support them...
Would a miracle be of any help to you? I would be most pleased if that were so. May we discuss miracles then?
We get the prayer gesture. We get the divine blessing. We get the heal and the great heal excerpt and the force and the great heal and the wrath of gods and the magic barrier. And then this garbage she can keep. If you want to quote unquote save Rhea, as in prevent her from dying or going hollow, don't buy all her miracles, because buying all her miracles causes her to get captured by the Serpent Men and brought to the Duke's archives, and then she just goes hollow and it's all sad and stuff. So leave a couple of miracles in her inventory and she'll just stay here for the rest of the game. Generally, you'd want to leave the garbage miracles in her inventory.
Then be safe. Farewell, Varianox.
Varian Nox, I think, was meant to be the catchphrase of this game in place of Umbasa from Demon's Souls, but never seems to have caught on within the community for some reason. I guess because Rhea is the only character other than, I think, one of the two cleric goofwads that accompany her, who actually use that phrase. So you almost never hear it throughout the game. Alright, and actually I think we'll kindle this bonfire, because this is a bonfire that you pass by fairly often. Not every bonfire is worth kindling. The ones that you only visit once, or the ones that are in locations where you have no reason to go, there's no real need to kindle those, but the ones along primary routes like this, right near Andre and whatnot, those are worth kindling all the way. Alright. And I think I'm going to call it here. So thank you all very much for joining me, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Take care, everybody.